nice to have E3 back this year, to have so many game announcements located within the course of basically a week. It's exciting for someone who's a huge fan of video games. But I thought it'd be fun to go over what some of my favorite announcements were. So here's the 10 that stood out the most to me. At the Xbox event, the game that I got most excited about was Replaced. This cyberpunk-looking side-scroller has some of the coolest-looking art that I've ever seen. Babylon's Fall is something that I'm bound to be excited about because I love everything that Platinum Games does. But this is coming from some of the people that did Nier Automata and Metal Gear Rising Revengeance, two games that I love. Here Comes Nico is a cute platformer with an amazing art style. It's so adorable, and you get to be co-workers with a frog. I did not expect this at all. I thought Nintendo had given up on Advance Wars. It was left only to indies. But Advance Wars 1 and 2 Reboot Camp is coming to us from WayForward, and I am just so excited by this game. Another one I didn't think we'd get is Metroid Dread. It's been a long time since we've gotten a new 2D Metroid, but that's finally changing now. It's coming this year. Speaking of dormant franchises, it's been a little bit since we've gotten a WarioWare game, and WarioWare Get It Together is going to be co-op into the mix, and I can't wait to play that with anyone in my house. Stranger of Paradise Final Fantasy Origins, from the people that made Nioh, are bringing us a Dark Souls-style Final Fantasy game. And that's all I need to know. But I totally love the demo as well. Speaking of Square Enix games, I was not expecting this Guardians of the Galaxy game. It looks so amazing, and I was shocked that it's coming out this year. And of course, the game that made the most buzz at E3, Elden Ring, finally got showed off. Really does look incredibly epic in what's happening there, and fans of everything that From Software does within the Dark Souls style of genre will be there day one, I'm sure, to pick this up. And I know everyone's excited about different things at E3. I'd love to hear what you were most excited about, but regardless of what you love most at E3, make sure to find the yay in every day. Bye.